Mr. Senate President, in a matter of days, the President will be delivering his State of the Nation address. What do you want to hear from the President? What do you want him to say?
With any President, Carmina, the true State of the Nation. We want to hear from the point of view of the President how our country is. And number two, we want to hear from the point of view of the President what he wants to do for the ensuing year, what help he needs from us. It would be nice. It would be a good opportunity, a nice opportunity for the Filipinos to listen to our highest leader in the land once a year at least, to talk about these things. When I was younger, Carmina, I used to say the sauna is sana. Because oftentimes I don't hear what I want to hear. Oftentimes I am disappointed and discouraged that some things were said or not said. That's why the sauna is sometimes referred to as sana by some of our people. Pero para sa akin, it may sound like a tongue twister. Sana yung sauna hindi matapos sa sana at lahat ng sana natin marinig natin sa sauna.
But Mr. Senate President, I asked you what you wanted the President to say, and as you correctly pointed out, you don't hear most of the time what you want to hear. So what do you think? You know what you want him to say, but what do you think you'll be hearing come sauna day?
I was not referring only to President Marcos.
Of course.
In fact, I was referring to the me during my younger years. Mm-hmm. I've learned to accept, instead of always looking for what I cannot see nor did not hear, I've learned to accept that we are different. And the President has a different perspective. He may not necessarily be wrong. I may be wrong. Because at the end of the day, giving due respect to our President, who perhaps has more information available to him than I ever would have, or than you ever would have. And I'd rather that he be honest with us and tell us what he sees, what he feels, and what he thinks he can do, instead of simply expecting him to be like me, thinking I'm Superman or Batman or can do anything and everything, when in fact it is not at all possible. I'd rather be frank with the people too than raise false hopes, Carmina.
On the issues, for example, of corruption, the West Philippine Sea, inflation, we haven't even talked about that. Where do you think the President's voice should be at its loudest?
I think inflation, because that's the number. All of the surveys, all of everyone interviewed by any media outfit would tell us that inflation is the number one issue in the mind of our citizens right now. The issue on the West Philippine Sea would be third or fourth down the road, and the issue of services and readily available services, especially medical services, would be an offshoot of the absence or presence or gravity of corruption in our country. So these three issues would definitely, I'm quite sure actually, would be included in the President's sauna, given that these are top of mind issues our countrymen are facing and talking about right now.
But what do you want to hear in terms of inflation and corruption?
What can be done and what will be done? I have my own views again, Carmina, which I do not want to impose upon the President. And after nearly 3 years in office, I guess he would be in a better position to tell us what he can do within his term, what he cannot do within his term, and what he would like to start doing before the end of his term, given that we are nearing the halfway mark.
And as we wrap up this conversation, Mr. Senate President, what to you is the real state of the nation?
For me, the real state of the nation would be the Philippines reeling off from the pandemic with serious economic problems. We're not yet where we want to be, but we're definitely on the way to where we would want to be.
Senate President Francis Escudero, thank you so much for taking time out, being with us today, and talking to us. Thanks again.
Thank you, Carmina. Thank you to our televiewers.